Welcome back to The Road Show. This morning in The Buzz, everyone you know it trying to achieve happiness on a daily basis. But a new study suggests that being too happy can actually make you unhappy.
Oh, no.
Yes, the study comes out of Yale University. Researchers there indicates that high levels of positive feeling predict risks of taking behaviors such as drugs and alcohol abuse. The study goes on to say that being too happy could even hamper your career. Researchers say those who don't experience much sadness or anxiety are rarely dissatisfied with their job and therefore feel less pressure to get more education or change careers. Psychologists also say emotions are healthy and help us survive. For example, anger prepares us to fight, while fear helps us flee.
Oh my goodness.
So are we all happy?
I feel like I shouldn't be anymore after all of that.
Yeah.
I can see why this is true, because let's say you don't have a care in the world,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which can be a good thing, but at the same time, so many things can be, you know, hitting your everyday life. You can be gullible.
Yeah.
You can, you know, maybe you're not sure what's going on in the news, so you're just going about your life like, la la la, skipping around. I don't have a care in the world. I'm so happy. Yet so many other things are going on around you. So,
that you're almost oblivious to it.
Right, exactly.
And don't we all just hate happy people?
Stop looking at me! I am not oblivious. I am downright happy, I can tell you that.
You know what? Mary is the happiest person I know. She absolutely is, no matter what is going on. She smiles.
But the question is, are you unhappy?
No.
Are you still happy that you're unhappy?
I read this study and I was like, not at all, buddy. I'm going to have to go to Yale and go talk to these
right.
people because, you know, I don't think I'm gullible, but maybe that's my problem. You know, I was reading also that when you go, if you're on trial for something, you're going to want to have, you know, a really happy jury because
yeah.
maybe they'll just have faith in you. And I definitely have faith in people and I'm definitely optimistic.
Mm-hmm.
But my gosh, I'm not, you know, going to go to use drugs and these other things that they're saying
yeah.
happy people are going to do.
Yeah.
I mean, I might have a really bad future ahead of me if I keep this up.
No, but some people, you know, I mean, I got nothing, you know, I'm happy, but I'm not over the top happy. You
girl,
know, we try
waiting.
To keep a status quo, you know. But I mean, there are some people who you can be around who are like, you
it's
know.
It's sickening. Okay. Like
it's
sugar.
Sickening,
it's
sweet
sickening.
Happy.
Sickening.
And there's nothing more aggravating. I hate to say that, but there really isn't.
Well, also, too, I mean, when you're unhappy, a lot of times, let's say something goes wrong in your life
mm-hmm.
somehow. Maybe you lose something. Maybe
yeah.
you're just not, you know, not as happy. You lose a game, even something
yeah.
as silly like that. But it almost makes you a better person for it because you learn to appreciate those times when things are going right.
Sure.
Yeah.
So maybe it in turn, you know, makes you appreciate things more. That's why I, you know, being unhappy, I feel, is normal.
Yeah.
You should be unhappy because that means you are feeling certain things.
Mm-hmm.
You do have emotions other than just that one.
But then you have the opposite. I mean, those people who are so unhappy, I mean, God bless them, but my husband, when the Patriots or the Red Sox lose, it is like the clouds are over our house for a day after the Super Bowl. I couldn't talk to him for an hour. I just sat on my iPad.
So do you guys clash? Because you
are
the one extreme.
Opposites. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but on the other hand, you know, yes, I'm very happy, but I like to think about myself as an optimist.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, when bad situations come up, I think you can be upset for a minute, but then you need to say, okay, what's the next step?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think you need to be oblivious. I know. I can tell.
I'm biting my tongue, and not because of you, but because I'm completely the opposite, I think. I can be Johnny Negative. Just ask anybody who's worked with me.
No, Johnny Negative. That's
a new
one.
You know, sometimes I'm a little, I could be gloom and doom sometimes, you know.
You seem
and I don't like to be
on this couch, though.
I'm thrilled.
Well, I wonder what people online are saying. Are they happy? Are they unhappy today? Mary, what did people
weigh
in?
Yeah, this study, of course, is quite interesting. So Richard Dershin says, it's better to live a life of emotional safety. No highs, no lows, just constant grayness, poor thing. Life is swings and roundabouts. Deal with it. I think Richard needs to have a dose of Mary in his life. Gosh.
Well,
not that kind of a
dose.
Your husband may not be so happy.
Oh, my gosh. Well, Dean Harrington says it's a typical nonsense from academic elites who are defining happiness here as being hard to deceive, good at winning arguments, and not possessing self-interest. That being the case, I'm officially miserable and darn happy about it.
Attaboy.
Is anyone happy online? Today.
Jay Devani says she's not going to lie, but she agrees with the findings of this study. She knows happy people who fit that description at a T, but sometimes she thinks the happy people are lucky and will probably have less wrinkles and live longer.